another one and give them. Oh gosh, let me tell you, I'm writing Booker this morning. I don't know. How you do it?
I'm not that cold this morning. Every other time I'm like freezing. I'm like, yo. Jesus, have mercy, this is crazy.
No, I'm living vicariously through you. All right, guys. So you look around your home and you feel like it either doesn't reflect who you are, mm-hmm. or worse, you've collected so many things over the time, over the years, from decor magazines that there's no cohesive look. Our decor style, everything is just checker. Check this, check that. Chaka. So, can you set us on track, whether we are contemporary, modern, whatever other style there is? DeZign Diva Karen Booker is here. Good morning to
Good
you.
Good morning, my love.
Warm
you?
Lady.
Yes.
So, let's talk about the different styles. You have traditional,
transitional, and
modern,
contemporary.
Okay.
Those are the big three.
So, modern, contemporary are really one.
No, they're not.
Oh.
Right? The modern is a really streamlined look, like minimalist.
Right.
Absence of
white.
Color. White.
Yes.
Monochromatic. Absence of color, emphasis on the metals. Mm-hmm. So it's a cold kind of look.
Okay.
Right? And feel. Because decorating is how you feel.
Yeah.
Right? The contemporary look now introduces a little bit more color.
Okay.
So the emphasis now is, while it's still streamlined, there is an accent pillow that has color. There is imposing and wonderful art that has a whole lot of color. And then there's texture in the rugs and so on.
Okay.
So that is the main difference. It's how you feel. It's a little warmer.
So like a loft setting, mm-hmm.
would be more
modern?
Transitional.
Oh, transitional.
Transitional now. In the transitional space, it takes its cues from the traditional setting and the contemporary. So there is a mix of both, and it's right in the middle. So therefore,
gotcha.
People are really comfortable in that transitional styling.
And then the traditional, right? is where
and
we have the whatnot.
Traditional, exactly. Traditional now takes its roots from the European design. It's like our mother's house or our grandmother's house, because that's what we knew,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So there, if you like symmetry, if you like balance, if you like order, if you like ornate, right? If you like pieces that are really heavily carved,
mm-hmm.
jewel tones in your paint, mm. And lots of over-the-top drapery.
Yes,
layers,
balances.
Balances along with your panels.
Plastic on your furniture.
No, that's just a mistake. That's just wrong.
But that's more traditional than anything
that's
else.
That's just function. That's our custom, because we just want the things last forever and ever. And then,
so Jamaica, you know, is more what? Traditional country, or are we transitioning?
We're traditional, still. Moving into, yes, with all the design classes that I have. And when we do these little contests, you know, and who's going to do traditional and so on, everybody usually picks the traditional, even though they want to do contemporary.
Mm-hmm.
That now would be, if you're drawn to that kind of styling,
that's traditional.
Then that is a traditional. When you look at the window treatment, because say in Jamaica, when you think decorating, you always think window treatment and pillows and whatnot and so on. So when you look at the window treatment, they're very ornate, very fussy, lots of details going on. That too can mm-hmm. be a very, very a traditional style. You can see from the rug, the dark
the table.
Wood furniture, exactly, mm-hmm. the table,
the
cabriole legs, mm-hmm. the big severe round in the arms, the window treatment again. So lots of layers, lots of textures there. So if you're drawn to that, because I hear this a lot from people, oh, I don't know whether I'm traditional, modern, contemporary, or transitional and so on. Chances are you're right in the middle.
Okay.
Right? Because we're living now, so therefore, you know, we're taking influences from what we know and what we are aspiring to.
Okay.
So even though we want to be contemporary and so on, we still have that traditional
roots. So we're evolving.
Okay. And we should. We're ever in the classroom.
Okay, gotcha. So that's traditional.
That is a traditional look. Sometimes you will see that it has a neutral palette in your walls, and then now the jumping off point now is all the drapery and the trimmings and so on, very Victorian style.
Okay.
All right. So the next one we should be looking at now is the transitional style.
Okay, so let's talk about the transitional style. We mentioned mm-hmm. elements of it earlier, but
there
let's delve a little deeper.
See that now. It is streamlined. It's pared
yeah.
down.
Yeah.
Right? It's more, it's interesting. It feels a little more relaxed. A little less formal, you know. It says, come sit here, come be with me.
It's warm.
It's warm.
Yes.
It's warmer. You will see that the table, instead of having the
curved legs,
this is now straight mm-hmm. legs and so on. You will see the arms in the sofa clean lines. You'll hear this a lot, clean lines, right? Look at the drapery now. The drapery is, there are panels. Mm-hmm. So we don't wear, so we're gone now.
With no valances.
No valances.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. And also you can do just blinds. And there are myriad, lots and lots of options of window treatment blinds now. You can see the light fixture there, you know, right in the ceiling. Mm-hmm. That is not the big chandelier, but it is streamlined, it is warm, it is friendly. Another thing with the transitional style, it is all about your personality. So you will see, you know, like Element, you put a typewriter here, you put some books here to warm up the space, to give you a connection to the past.
Yes.
So it's about your personality. It's okay. About, right, infusing things that you love into the space.
Isn't that, wouldn't right? that be true for all spaces though? Mm-hmm. Because don't all spaces kind of speak to who you are?
A lot of it, because we just want to get it right, especially in the traditional mm-hmm. space, it is more formal.
Gotcha.
So you think that, okay, I have to go with the book here and I have to make sure that this goes well and so on. You know, so
less,
therefore...
Less flexibility, right, more rigidity.
Right. So it's less about you. Yeah, it's more about the space that just has to look good.
Not my team.
Right, and not that is when now you go into the living room or you bypass the living room. It's a drive-by.
Yeah, you can't sit there because you can't touch.
That's a drive-by living room.
No.
A transitional living room or a den is a place where it's warmer. It says, come in, come and enjoy me. Come plop, come have some conversation.
All right, let's see the next picture.
So
what is this now, modern?
Should be a contemporary space.
All right, so until we get there.
There you go.
That's me, girl.
That is you.
That is me.
That is you. That is you. The only thing that's missing there with you is a little the inspirational... stickers and
for
and
sure.
Pieces. Exactly.
Full of them.
It's full of
you
that.
You know this.
Right.
Message boards and
all of that, you know, which will inspire and so on. So
and I could use more pops of color
and
in
more
here.
So this one really is a modern space, right? Because you can see the emphasis. It's a monochromatic mm-hmm. setting and just one pop of color and mm-hmm. it is the yellow. Mm-hmm. And it comes up now in your painting, in one chair and the throw.
Yeah.
After that, that's it. It's minimalist. There's no, it's functional. It's aesthetically pleasing. There's nothing about it that you'll, there's nothing unnecessary in this. Men are attracted to this kind of look because you know them and the toss pillows and so mm-hmm. on. It's like, there's mm-hmm. no use.
Even though
them
and the white don't really work so good. Mm-hmm, but mm-hmm. if we were to contemporarize this, we could put some more pops of color.
Some more pops of color.
Okay, the throws.
Exactly. Some more, you know.
Pillows.
And a rug.
And a
great
rug.
Looking rug with some color.
And
then
warmth.
you would draw the color from that now as inspiration. And mm-hmm. then, of course, some more art and great accessories. That would make that space more contemporary.
That was a very cool lesson.
Thank you,
you
very
really
much,
just
darling.
Cleared it all up in my head for me, actually. Yeah. Excellent. Yeah. Are you having any more classes before the end of the year?
No, our last class was last week.
Okay.
Right? But our next set of classes will be in the spring, in March.
Okay.
So March,
in
and
the
it
spring.
Will run.
You're
right.
Such a foreigner.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Oh, but in the meantime, she's a foreigner. She can't help
she
herself.
She can't help herself.
If it is that you want your space to be done in any of the styles that Booker just mentioned, then mm-hmm. you just need to find her. She's at the waterfront.
Waterfront.
Or you can find her at her new location.
Right, which is 96 Hope Road. And please call us 876-421-6298. And this weekend, we're having the big sale. The big one. Up to 50 off, 62. But up to, the big one. It is big, it is huge. We're all going to give you wine and cake and all them something.
I'll see you on the weekend.
Yes, come. It is going to be huge. Instagram people, please. I can't take any more friend requests. We're over the limit. And, you know, so please go to Instagram, Karen Design Diva Booker on
Excellent.
IG. Yeah.
All right, guys. Shopping weekend.
Yes.
And lots of gifts, too, if you like people who love those signboards. She has a lot of them.
Holy
fam,
inspire you.
Thank you very much, Booker.
You're welcome, my darling.
Karen Booker, Design Diva, in with us this morning.
Bye.